Yo, what's good, YouTube? It's Boardsy, and this is going to be a rundown of all the mouse pads that I actively test going into 2024. This is similar to the style of video that Fresh Reviews made, like the yearly roundups. I really enjoyed those. And the way I set up my mouse pads, I just have one main stack where there's a few pads I'm testing and a lot of artisan pads. So this is just going to be kind of explaining what that stack is. So at the top, it's in no order, but this is the Shitinkai V2. Xsoft, and a lot of people have been asking me how this has held up, and obviously day in, day out, this is not my main mousepad, but I have been testing it a lot with various different mice, skates, and there has been no noticeable like decline in speed, any type of inconsistency throughout the surface. So if you are looking for a pure speed pad without like buying a slab of glass, I do think the updated Shitinkai V2 is one of the better pads on the market. Next up is the Artisan Raiden, and this is another speed pad. Obviously, I imagine a lot of you guys are familiar with the Raiden. At some point around a year ago, maybe a little bit more, it underwent a little change to the weave to reduce the issue that caused spinouts, and in general, it slowed down the pad a little bit. And despite it being a fast pad with low initial friction and dynamic friction, there's just still like a comfortable locked-in feeling when you're moving the mouse around on the axis of the pad. It's hard to describe, but even though it is faster, it doesn't feel like you have such little control when you compare it to something like a Shitinkai. So a Raiden is just another incredibly good smooth speed pad. And nobody has really cloned it yet with artisan level quality. Like the Lamzu Energon, I just don't fucking use that. The GameSense LiDAR, it's nice, but it has the rubber base. So if you want a Raiden, you kind of still have to go for a Raiden. This is the X-Ray Pad Aqua Control Pro Mid, but it's the black version. The neon version I'm going to talk about later in the video. It's like at the bottom of the stack. That is one of my favorite pads of 2023, but the black version just plays like a shitty, like dense weave Heian clone. It's just too slow for my preference when it comes to a hybrid pad, and it just, I could not have had a more drastic difference in my experience with the black version compared to the neon. So the black, unless you want a slow hybrid pad, don't even consider it. And even if you do want that, I would still go for the neon one because I think that's better. But it is cool to see X-Ray Pad have some higher quality products. This is the La Onda Pad Blitz from the Whale. And yeah, a lot of people have their opinions on the Whale. More people hate him than love him, I would imagine. But yeah, I've tried both versions of the Blitz, the mid and the soft, and I definitely do prefer something like an Artisan Zero X Soft, just in terms of surface texture, like feedback feeling. But this is a very like smooth, balanced pad. I would say it's like somewhat close to speed though. So it's not going to be like your super slow control pad, which honestly, I don't know if I even have a single one of those in this fucking stack. Maybe one of the Whale's other pads. But yeah, this is definitely the type of pad I like with the 500 by 500 size. I think it's certainly worth considering if you're in EU or somewhere where you can get the pad for cheap as like an Artisan Zero just type of pad. Once again, I don't think it really clears it in any aspect, but just using this in game, it's a very safe, comfortable pad. And I don't think I've had any issues with it. I definitely prefer the soft to the mid, and it would be interesting to see what an X soft is like. I believe this is an IPU base. It's not like true Japanese Poron, but it's also not like the base that X-Ray Pad is using. So all in all, I say the Blitz, I mean, absolutely a top tier pad. And it did release this year, so this is one of the few newer pads that I actually believe to be a banger. I still plan to make a roundup of all the Whale's pads if you are looking for more info. Now we have one of the 4114 pads, and I'm not gonna lie, these got a lot of hype. And yeah, ultimately, at one point, they sold out. I don't know if it's ever gonna come back in stock, but I was planning to make a roundup of these, and I just did not have a great experience with it. Like, especially if my room would get warm or if it was just more humid out, the static friction would just become super fucking muddy, where it's like it would be genuinely slow. But out of the box, this pad just had a very fresh, light glide feeling to it. So definitely just beware of surface inconsistencies, I guess, would be the one thing. The design on this one isn't bad. It really just looks perfectly fine. But the other one, it's in here somewhere, has that like fucking defaced Fruit Ninja head Marcus Aurelius. Like, I just thought this design was absolutely insane. But yeah, really, I don't have anything against 4114, but I just don't think that these mouse pads are revolutionary, changing the game quality-wise. Mouse pads, I just haven't even spoken much on it because everybody has a fucking Poron substitute base. all of the factories in China have gotten the stitching down to pretty much surface level. So all of these things that used to be like big quality assessments during a mousepad review, you just don't really need to talk about them anymore. So yeah, 4114, the pad itself is high quality. The surface I was just not huge on. Performance wise, like yes, out of the box, it was a solid speed pad. But yeah, I just can't say that this is something that I've put significant time on or that I plan to in the future. Now we have some classics, two Artisan Zero X Softs. We have the orange one and then the black version. I pretty much only use the orange one at this point because it is newer and because it is orange. Does anything more need to be said? I mean, the Artisan Zero, about as safe as you can get when picking up a control pad. There are all of the others, like the Blitz, the Lethal Gaming Gear Saturn Pro, Endgame Gear EMC that are like pretty much just trying to be zeros. What is this? Is this a Hayate Otsu or a Hien? I'm not looking, but I can just tell it's an Otsu. And yeah, this is my wine red Otsu mid that I've had since whenever they released this colorway. And it's a pad, like this specific unit that I've never loved, but I've just used it a ton. My unit is very dirty, nasty looking, so I just personally don't put a lot of time on it for that reason. The surface itself does have that very aggressive feedback. Like if you ever just look at it, you can recognize the Otsu based on its weave. And yeah, it's just a nice pad. If I were to buy the pad again, I'd probably go for the soft variant just so I do have a little bit more plushiness, a little bit thicker of a pad than the mid. But yeah, this is, it was one of my most used hybrid pads probably in the earlier half of the year, but now I just have not been using it as much. But whenever I just swipe a mouse on it, use it in game for a little bit, it just plays perfectly fine with really any skates. And yeah, if you're a fan of the Otsu, I understand why, and you probably don't want to switch off it to any other like hybrid pads or God forbid something smooth. This I'm not really going to talk about much. It's just the Shidenkai V2 mid version, which I definitely have not put nearly as much time on compared to the X-Soft. I don't know why. See, the GPX skates I have on for some reason look like they're playing pretty slow on this. I feel like part of the appeal of the Shidenkai is that it's not like a firm glass pad. So even though the mid surface is not like specifically glass, like there is going to still be a little bit of give. I just feel like the X-Soft is a lot more unique of a speed pad experience. So like I would opt for that over the mid version. This is a Hien mid, which similar to the Otsu mid has just been the main variant that I've been testing it on. Throughout the years, I've had this Hien Soft, which I think I've had for over 3 years now. I got to make an update on this at some point. I'll do a little glide comparison between a less used Hien mid, like a year and a half old, and then the Hien Soft, which is multiple years old. You guys can see this is valuable science. And my OG Hien still isn't dead. Like, is that not... there's something to be said about that. Like, this thing looks like a mess. It has been through a lot, multiple apartments, many games, many generations of mice, and ultimately it still performs. I have not washed this thing in God knows how long. I just used a little bit of Lysol disinfectant spray, if so. So Artisan pads, at the end of the day, what I'm coming to realize is Artisan is still the GOAT. And for me personally, nothing else is really even close. Just in terms of like what I genuinely use is on my desk, it's dominated by Artisan. Now we have, I believe this is the Nacho Customs X the Whale Riz design, and this is just a fucking super weird pad to me. It is very controlled, but it just feels like it's almost like has like a plastic laminate over it. I just don't even know how to describe this surface. So yeah, this is hands down one of the slower pads I have tested. It's definitely not something that I enjoy or is for me, but it's just with the Whale's other pads. I have been testing it in preparation for a roundup, and I feel like this is similar to the X-Ray Pad Minerva just in terms of surface style, but that's not as spongy, and this just does have a slightly different feeling. Obviously, quality-wise, it's solid, and I actually do like the doodle-style design. I just like black and white designs in general. But yeah, the pad surface itself, stay tuned for some more thoughts on that when I do the Whale mousepad roundup. This thing, like the Fantech Strike Pad Pro, get it away from me. Like, I don't even know how it snuck into here. I'm going to decide to cut that section out because, you know, there's no reason for me to just go in on the Fantech Strike Pad Pro. But ultimately, just don't buy it is what I would say. Now we have the GameSense Radar Boardsy Edition. This is an absolute classic Zebra Radar. It's definitely a slower control pad than most of the other options out there. And it has been in the rotation. I'm not going to pretend this is the number one pad on the market with a rubber base. But I mean, everything else, it's just a basic, it's a safe pad. It has not gone to shit in terms of durability. And yeah, especially with lighter mice like the WO Mouse ULX, this did get some solid testing. So I have no shame in plugging it as a solid control pad, and I believe at the end of the year, the design will no longer be available. And yeah, now next up is going to be one of the last pads, actually, is the Saturn Pro. And this probably just has kind of fallen out of the rotation just due to having the LaundaPad Blitz, enjoying the Artisan Zero X Soft, but it's still like one of the top control pads that I would go for. I believe it's like $55 before using a code for this 500 by 500 size, and it's just ultimately a extremely high quality, solid performing control pad. There's nothing I can say that hasn't been said already, aside from the fact that it is holding up in terms of durability and consistency. But now here, last but not least, saving the best for last, however you want to put it, this might be the most underrated pad of the year, or just personally, one of the pads I've been enjoying most. I've had it in the background of so many videos. People are asking me what it is, and it's the X-Ray Pad Aqua Control Pro Mid Neon. I don't know why I like this so much. I obviously have an idea of why. It is a Heian clone, and that is something that I've always liked. It is perfect quality, which was just surprising to see. Like I've said, just so much higher quality than anything X-Ray Pad has put out. But I was actually sent by a viewer a picture of this pad's weave under a microscope compared to a Heian, and it's probably the closest weave I've seen to a Heian on any pad. So it just makes a lot of sense. This is heat treated, which is why it feels so much different and faster and better than the black variant I spoke about previously in this video. But yeah, just something about this pad, it just has that light feeling where it feels like your mouse skates are grazing on the surface, and it just has been a joy to use all around. I don't have a single complaint about the pad, and it is more expensive at $70, I believe. There is no shipping cost, but I think that's like the same price, if not a little bit more than a Artisan pad shipped to the US. This is, of course, a 500 by 500 size, so it is a bit larger. That's another thing that factors in. I really enjoy the size, but it is, if you're looking for like a Heian clone, a hybrid pad, I think that they're going to be on a Christmas sale at some point, and it's just like, it's one of the pads to consider. And yeah, normally I would just say get the Heian, like no questions asked, but this is the first Heian clone that I feel like is high quality in the way that we've had high quality Zero clones for a while, if this makes sense. But yeah, I just don't even know what to say. This is maybe the mid variant, but it feels somewhere between like mid and soft, probably closer to mid. So it's not going to be an extremely plushy pad. I will bust out the first lighter test of the video. With all of the pads stacked up, a lighter test just would have been kind of useless. But yeah, this is a pad that I've just put a ton of time on since getting it. And I did not expect to. I expected it to be like, this is just a waste of money. Just go for a Heian, but really not the case. Like I have expressed numerous times. I guess last but not least is going to be the Glaze from the Whale. And this is a pad where, again, it has been hyped up a lot as the first glass pad you don't need a sleeve on. And I've put a lot of time on this, and there are some situations where my arm does still get stuck, but I would say much less so than something like a Sky Pad or a Super Glide pad. For me personally, I'm not using a sleeve on any glass pad I use, and this has been one of the more pleasant ones. It's kind of hard to see, but it's fucking huge. It's 600 by 500 millimeters, and I think the pricing is pretty competitive. When you account for like the size, it's still under $100, but SkyPads have been on massive sales, and I just have not tested this enough head to head compared to other glass pads, but I would say it's definitely on like the medium speed side. It's not the fastest glass pad I've ever used, but it's not like a muddy thing like the TJ exclusive Sarah pad. And yeah, so I'm not in love just because I don't think I'm ever gonna love a glass pad, but this is very solid as well. Stay tuned for the Whale roundups. If there are any other must-see mouse pads that I have to review, let me know in the comments below. But I just figured that would be a way to show like what I'm actually using, like what is in my top tier mouse pad stack going into 2024, because I have literally hundreds of mouse pads, and I would say most of them, at least 80%, just never get touched. So that's the truth about mouse pads. I'm still an Artisan fanboy, say what you will. I see all of these other reviewers who just haven't gotten to the point in mouse pads where you just realize Artisan's had it figured out forever, and that's what you should be putting most of your time on. But yeah, really, I mean, at this point, there are just so many high quality options. You can pretty much go with anything aside from the Fantech Strike Pad Pro, and you will be solid. Make sure to leave a like and subscribe if you enjoyed the video, want to see more mouse pad content in the future. But that's going to be all. Peace.